Hello, I'm here on video today to talk a little bit about picture weaving with AdaCAD. So picture weaving is a process of using woven structures to create different shades of colors and arranging them so that they look almost like photographs or different pictures. And AdaCAD is a software that I've been building with students to support weavers and also offers support for picture weaving such as this. So on the left here, we actually have an example of a picture weave. The general technique that's being used in picture weaving is that you have a contrasting color in the warp and weft, such that if you're using a warp face structure that has more lowered wefts, more warp overs than warp unders, you see more of that warp color. And then you can kind of adjust that so that you can see more of the weft color by changing the structure. So these create these kind of like shades of grayscale. So the process of making a picture weave essentially starts with an image. And the image you can break down into lots of different shades of different colors. So in this case, I think they probably broke down the image into these graphical regions of different scales and shades of gray. So if we look closer at the picture, what you can actually see is happening is that all the little pieces where we're seeing those black spots, I forget exactly how this particular tapestry is made, but is a place where if the warp is black, the warp is being lifted over the weft. And in the places where you see white, it's where the white is being lifted over the black warp. So the structure that you're using to weave directly kind of corresponds to what you're going to see in the image. So if we can think of different structures being shaded, shaded meaning that if you weave them with alternating warps and wefts, you can shift the color by shifting the structure. We can see even in the draft that different colors become more prominent. So if your black, your weft warp is black and your weft is white, chances are it's going to look even very similarly to these drafts. So what we see here is you can actually map these different shaded structures to different regions. So let's talk a little bit about how we're going to do that. So, oh, here's a little extra information I have on that. So what you're going to do first is you're going to convert your image into a reduced color space. So the image on the right is a full color image, and there may be, depending on what kind of image format you're using, I don't know, hundreds, thousands of different individual pixel colors being used. When you create an indexed color version of that image, like this one shown on the left, and which is featured on the Wikipedia article about indexed color, you see that it sort of groups the colors into different regions. So we've gone from a color space on the right of a few hundred or a thousand to a color space on the left, which is just four images. What we can do then in our drafts is fill each of these color regions with a different structure. And that's actually what AdaCAD will let us do. So here I'm just showing an image of the AdaCAD screen using the image map feature. So here we've actually uploaded that same parrot from Wikipedia, and we've created all these different structure generators for shaded satins and plugged them in. So let's actually just go over to AdaCAD and look at this. So this is the AdaCAD interface. The AdaCAD interface basically has this gray workspace where you can create drafts by connecting different operations together. On the top here, you have just simple links to learning about AdaCAD and getting help. You have some links to clear your screen or download the workspace to work on it later, or even open a new file. On the right here are all the different design tools you can use in AdaCAD. The most important one that we're going to be using in this sketch is the operations, and specifically the image map operation. Okay, so when I click it there, you see it ends up on the screen. So to give us a sense of where we're going, I've just gone ahead and made a few image maps with a few different structures. Here I'm using the zoom tools to play with this. So here I have different shaded satins. And if I assign each satin to a different color in the image, you can see how it affects how the image is read. The nice thing about AdaCAD is that since all of these operations are connected together, almost like a little conveyor belt or assembly line, a change in one will actually ripple down. So you can see like, okay, if I make this much bigger, I'm seeing a lot more black and a lot less white. But maybe I also want this to be a slightly more distributed kind of satin. I can move the offset value to do that. Maybe I want to flip the color altogether. I can shift it from warp facing to weft facing. So with this kind of model, it makes it a little easier to just start doing your shaded structures by eye and actually live modifying the different regions until you can kind of get the resolution that you want or the best image quality. So in this example, I'm using satins, which is a really common structure to use for shading. But you can also use any structure that has a variable ratio of warps lifted to warps lowered. So here I've actually created this structure that isn't a real weave structure, but is a structure that computers are good at called random. And it just randomly lifts and lowers cells in a draft based on some percentage. So if you want it to be 90% warp facing, you use 90 here. If I want it to be 10%, it turns white, right? Because it's only gonna lift 10% of those warps. So let's go back to 90 because we want this to correspond to black. So here you can see that I'm actually filling the structure with a slightly different shaded structure this time. I also have these other support features, and this happens in picture weaving sometimes, that when you make your satins too big, there's a risk that you might forget to bind some of the floats, which makes your weave structure really floppy. So one thing you can do to just ensure that your structures work out well is to use this bind weft floats and bind warp floats. And what that does is it actually takes this input draft. So let me actually remove it and I'll show you how to do this. We take this input draft, we take the output here saying, okay, take this draft and put it into the function that says bind weft floats. If we look at the draft here, we see, okay, now none of the weft floats are gonna be longer than 10. And we can space that out to be even longer if we like, or shorter if we like. Of course, if you're not allowing any floats longer than one, you're going to get something strange. That'll only bind your weft floats. So if you want to bind your warp floats, you go ahead and say bind warp floats. You come in here. I like to just hide this image. I take the output and I put it in here, and then I can see it again and start adjusting those parameters. So this is just a way to help your drafts be really well structured. So let's go to another example. So if we actually scroll down a little bit, I have another example of shaded structures that's just using different variations on a tabby weave. So where I have a true tabby here that's alternating over under, I can actually shift some of the tabbies here to make them uneven, more like rep structures, or a little more blocky. And again, we can just sort of play live and see what the effect of that is. The last example I have of this is using a function that I developed together with Marianne Fairbanks called All Possible Structures. And All Possible Structures uses algorithmics, uses a process called combinatorics to generate every possible combination of a 4x4 structure. And there's almost 15,000 different combinations. So what I do here is I just plugged them all in and then I choose a different structure from that list. And I just visually see if it gives me the quality that I want. So if I want to come over here and make the black regions a little bit darker, I can just keep flipping through until I find a structure that's maybe on the darker side, such as that one. So one of the other things that I think is really helpful here is that what's deceptive when you map images to woven cloth is that in an image, all of your pixels are a perfect square. And when you weave, they're going to be rectangular in one or the other direction, depending on your loom settings. So oftentimes you're going to weave a sample and see how distorted it is, and then modify the draft so that you kind of correct that distortion. So let's say you weave this pair at once and it's really squished. Well, you know, you actually have to stretch the draft then. So it accounts for that as you're weaving, it's going to compress a little bit more. And in AdaCAD, you can actually do that by just changing this parameter called draft height. So if I want to stretch this image that's one square, 200 pixels, if I want to make it twice as long as it is tall, I change this to 400. And here I could see how that actually changes the regions, but not the structures. So the structures fill as they would normally, which is quite nice and maintain some of your ratios, while the image itself gets quite a lot bigger. So before I end this video, which I have 3 minutes to do, I wanna actually walk through the whole process. So creating an indexed color image, uploading it to AdaCAD, and assigning different structures to it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna exit full screen. I'm going to stop sharing my screen, and I'm going to open an image in Photoshop that I would like to do a picture weaving of, and then I'll share that. So here is an image of a woven, which is very meta to weave a woven, that I would like to weave. So if I were actually going to weave this image, it would have, again, tons and tons of colors. So the first thing I need to do is actually change the color space here. I'm going to zoom in just so we can kind of see what the original colors look like. So I'm going to go in Photoshop to Image, Mode, and then there's a mode called Indexed Color. I hope you can see this. Let me stop sharing and then reshare. Okay, so here's the actual interface, and then I'll go back to it. But you have all these different settings for indexed color. It's going to default to these ones that are like system, which is 256 colors, or windows. When you were weaving, we usually want a really small color space because we're going to have to assign structures to all the regions. So I usually use this local adaptive and then tell it how many colors I'm willing to use. And I update this while looking at the image to see what gives me the best trade-off between a small color space and kind of clarity of imagery. So I'll actually go back to Photoshop now so you can actually see the effect of this. So I'm going to open indexed color mode again. Sorry about that. Here it comes. So I'll go back to RGB, then I go to indexed color, go to local, and now as I change the colors, the number of colors, you can see that there's more or less in the image itself. So I found that 14 is kind of a nice number, and I'm going to leave it there. So AdaCAD actually can't process the image match feature with more than 100 colors. So you have to keep that color space down below 100. And once you have it where you like it, you can save it as a JPEG or a PNG. So I'm going to save it as a PNG. And let's go ahead and close this and go back to AdaCAD. Okay, so in AdaCAD here, I am going to clear my screen. And then I'm going to open the feature called Imagemap. Okay, in Imagemap, I am going to navigate. Oh boy. Navigate to that image I just saved. Here we go. And I'm going to upload it. So now we can see all of the colors that were found in this image. And I'm going to choose how I want to map those colors to different structures. So let's say we want to do a shaded satin. I'll add a shaded satin here. And let's say we're going to use a bunch of different shaded satins. I'll just keep duplicating it. All right, these regions look almost the same color. So I'm going to put them together. And I'm going to create a mostly weft facing color here. I'm going to even go down one. All right, that's pretty weft facing. To contrast that, I will actually do a warp facing structure here in the black regions. And then everything in between, I can kind of alternate. So let's do that there. I might not get to all of these in this video, but you can at least start to see how it works. The other thing that AdaCAD does, just to make the image smaller, is it reduces it by a factor of 10. So the actual image here, if we zoom in, you can see. Where did it go? Hold on. Come back. Oh, weird. I was kind of in the middle of the workspace. We can just make this bigger. So let's make it 1,000 by 667, which is the original size. And now you can actually see a little more of those details coming through because the regions are bigger. I'm actually gonna kind of reduce the space again so we can see it. Okay. All right, and so actually let's go. Is this working? Here we go. So now as I change these colors, even though I can't even see what these numbers are, I can change them and see what the effects are. And I'm seeing sort of darker regions coming into play and lighter regions coming into play. So I hope this gets you started. This is just a short intro to picture weaving with AdaCAD. An important step, if you would like to actually weave this, you can select a button on the left that says download and download it as bitmap and upload it to your Jacquard machine. Thank you so much.